Welcome to my channel, The Three Mountains. My name is White Eagle. Today we are going to continue analyzing the different stages of liberation that Master Samael teaches in one of his lectures. Now, in this video, we are going to talk about the solar man, and we're going to talk about the psychological sun that we must create inside us. Again, this sun is for illustration purposes only, and it was my son who colored it for me. Now, let us begin. The solar man. The next step is to become a solar man. If someone wants to become a solar man, then he or she must create inside himself or herself the psychological sun. In the previous stage, the person created the superior existential bodies of the being. In this stage, those bodies created by the salt, sulfur, and mercury must attach to themselves the gold. The gold gets multiplied by eliminating the dry mercury, that is the ego, and the arsenic sulfur, that is the infernal fire of the abominable Kundartiwator organ. So this is what I refer to as the perverted fire in my previous videos, which is created by having had orgasms. Now, whoever eliminates those two elements, the dry mercury and the arsenic sulfur, then the atoms of gold will get attached to the superior existential bodies of the being. And these bodies will then get transformed into bodies of gold. And this is a process that belongs to the second mountain. And I wrote down here the Superman, because Master Samael speaks about the Superman in many of his lectures. It is for you to understand what he's talking about. Now, when this happens, the solar man is born. He or she has created inside himself or herself the psychological sun. This is carried out by descending to the ninth sphere, the inferior dimensions or hells of each one of us. Just a moment, let's continue. And with working with the vitriolo. The vitriolo, he or she will create the gold. The spirit of the gold is in the sacred sperm, and the great masters of alchemy have their sperm in gold. If one does not work with alchemy in the ninth sphere, then it is not possible to multiply in the cup of Hermes the salt, the sulfur, and the mercury, that is the vitriolo. Now, what is vitriolo or vitriolum? Well, which is with a V, not with a U. Vitriolum are the letters for an alchemical phrase that means visita interiora terrae rectificando invenies occultum lapidem veram medicinam. That is in Latin, which means visit the interior of the earth, and by rectifying it, you will find the occult stone, that is the true medicine. Now let us analyze vitriolo. The first letter stands for visit. It's an invitation to go on a journey, but not with the physical body, the soma, but with our soul, the sikh. All initiates must do this journey, no matter to what tradition he or she belongs. It can be a person from the east or the west. This is a journey where we must descend to the hells in order to be reborn. And here we have examples of people who have done this journey, like Jesus, Dante, Samael, Aunweo, etc. Let us continue, just a moment. Now the next letter is interiora. The journey leads us to our own particular interior, our particular hells, in order to purify it. This teaches the initiate that the battle is not outside, towards people outside, but inside us. And then we have Aristotle, who says that whoever defeats himself or herself becomes invincible. The next letter is Terai. Earth, it means earth, where the seed dies, so the plant is born. So the charcoal becomes a diamond. And Master Samael repeats many times in his lectures, and he says, unless the seed dies, the plant can't be born, right? The next letter is rectifying, which means to put it right, to correct, to make it pure again. Why or how, sorry? By chiseling the stone, to sublimate. We separate the dense from the subtle. This means to separate the putrefaction that envelops the soul. Then the virtues will start appearing or flourishing with the cleansing of the essence from the egos. The next word is invenious. It means to find, to look for. It is an active process, and unconscious one, that allows us to know ourselves. And the last four letters, occultum, lapidem, veram, medicinam. The occult stone is the true medicine. It is the philosophical stone of the ancients. Just a moment, we continue. Now, there are two types of vitriolo, the pure and the impure. The impure is a compound of salt, sulfur, and mercury that is sunk inside a mass made up of phlegm and dead soil. This is called the green lion by the alchemists. So if you see pictures with a green lion, now you know what it means. Once the phlegm and the dead soil are cleansed or eliminated, then the pure vitriol appears and is symbolized by the red lion. I think that tarot card number 11, you will see a red lion there. You can check it out. In occult masonry, this is called the cubic stone, already chiseled and free from impurities. This is the primordial man. Now, Master Samael continues with his lecture by saying that the bodies of gold can receive the Christ, the Logos. If one does not multiply the gold in the cup of Hermes, then Christification cannot be achieved. Only a man totally Christified is a solar man. Now let us continue. I'm going to end this video, and I wanted to give you an example of vitriolo. And I chose the Apostles' Creed, and I took just some phrases because the Apostles' Creed tells a story. And if you take a look at it, but in an esoteric way, now you are able to understand, you know, the esoteric, hidden occult. It says, I believe in God the Father, Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. This part refers to Keter. This is here, the Father, God, in the Kabbalah tree. Yes? The first Sephiroth. I believe in Jesus Christ. Now I put Jesus between parentheses because here we have two different things. One is Jesus, the person who also did the path. And if you take a look at the Bible, at the beginning, you know, he's just known as Jesus. But then, or he's called Jesus. But later on, once he incarnates the Christ, then he becomes Jesus Christ in the Bible. So there you can see that the Christ, yes, refers to the second Sephiroth, Chokmah. This is the Son, the Christ, and is a cosmic force. And you need to incarnate this in the second mountain to become Christified, yes? And that's why here in the Apostles' Creed says that Christ is his only Son, the Son of the Father, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit. What is the Holy Spirit? The thought, the fire, right? We need the fire when doing alchemy, yes? In order to awaken the Divine Mother Kundalini. That's why the Creed, the Apostles' Creed continues by saying, and born of the Virgin Mary. The Virgin Mary is the Divine Mother Kundalini. There you can see the process. He descended to the dead, right? Who descended to the dead? Master Jesus descended to the dead. Here you have the vitriolo in action, that he went to look for this occult stone and to chisel the stone, to work with the stone, yet inside his own inferior dimensions or hells. And then on the third day, he rose again. This is the third mountain. The second mountain is called the mountain of crucifixion, but the third mountain is called the mountain of resurrection. It's not that we are talking about 3 days, okay? It's a process. And then he ascended into heaven. Up to here, I leave you with this image. These are the three important Sephira: Kether, the Father, the second Sephira is the Christ, and of course the third one is the Holy Spirit, Binah. And what is all this? The Trinity, the Holy Trinity, right? See you in my next video, where we will continue with Master Samael's lecture on the path of liberation. Thanks for watching.